certainly in favor of Texas. You know, if Rice can't run the football, I don't know what they're going to be able to do to shorten that margin.
I tell you what, they have been able to run the football. The Texas defense has been swarming. They've been very, very good on defense. And the same thing on offense. They've been very efficient, Bill. Everything has gone the way of Texas. Just look at the rushing yardage here. This football game for Rice, not able to get it done, minus 13. That takes into account negative plays by the quarterback. But overall, total yardage in this football game is just all in the favor of Texas and doing a great job with it there. And you just see the number of big plays that they've had in this football game. Texas offensively, 9 of those and averaging now over 9 yards per play. So it's been a good offensive performance and defensive performance overall for Mac Brown's Longhorns. So now let's go down for the field. More.
And you know, we talked about, obviously, both teams want to get through a game healthy, but in Texas' situation where they're getting ready for conference play and comfortable margin adds to the pain of losing a player with an injury. And the touchback will give Rice the football, first and 10 from the Owl 20-yard line. Tyler Smith decided not to bring it out of the end zone. And the Owls get the first possession here in the second half, trailing 41-7. And Chase Clement will come out with the first half performance of 7 completions, Gary, for 10 yards.
Well, he's done some good things.
21, I'm sorry.
He's done some good things back there. He's got an accurate arm. He's a good mobile quarterback. And they're just running into a buzzsaw here with talent from the defensive side for Texas. They've been able to catch up with just about everything that Rice has attempted to accomplish on the football field. And they just got to get some positive plays together and string those together. That was what Tom Herman told us when we talked to him this week. They need to get some consistency going offensively, and it hasn't happened yet.
Hands a football off in the back, and Hill out to about the 25-yard line, Deion Beasley. And the whole game changed, does it not, when you can get 5 on first down?
Sure.
So now you have some options.
You got different things these are able to do. Change your personnel a little bit here. Justin Hilton coming out of the ball game, and they're bringing in another running back there. Marcus Knox into the ball game for the first time, I believe.
Knox, a sophomore from Houston. You know, a couple of plays in the first half they threw to him. And Clement sees something he doesn't like, changing the play now at the line. Still plenty of time with 10 on the play clock. Second and 4. Running game going nowhere this time as Tyler Smith brought down.
And Derek Loki, just one of the strongest guys on that front there. Let's watch number 96 get off of a block, split the double team right there and go through it. Just a tremendous athlete inside. Big, agile, 6'2", 295 pounds. And think of Derek Loki, you think of a guy who's just got a high motor, very strong, very intelligent, knows how to play this game in there, and is an impact player from the defensive tackle position.
Third and 5 of the 25 now, after that loss of a yard on a play. Smith again, the tailback to the quarterback Clement. 2 on the clock, just got it snapped in time. Jump ball, and it is incomplete. Palmer defending on the play, nearly picked it off. Intended for Dixon, who scored their only touchdown.
Yeah, almost a pick there early in this second half for the Longhorns. Ball thrown out there, under a little bit underthrown here, I think, by Clement on this throw. Wanted to get a little bit deeper, but didn't get it there, and Dixon had to come back and be the defender on that one himself. It's a nice play on the football, though, in the secondary.
That'll bring on Luke Juist to punt it away here.
He's had a mixed bag tonight punting the football, that's for sure. It's a good ball right there.
Taken on the 23 by Vaughn Cosby. Splits at 30, 35, 40, and Cosby. Ankle grab near the 46-yard line. A 52-yard punt that time by Juist. And Juice made the tackle. It's about the fifth time this year he's made the tackle. He's not a foot. And Texas has the football to start their first possession in the second half at the 46-yard line of the Longhorns with 13:08 to go in the third quarter. Bill Land, along with Gary Reasons, Emily Jones here on FSN. And this one passed and complete. Crossed the 50, and then Finley, helmet went flying from the tackler of Rice. That was really Garley who made the stop.
Heard Mac Brown coming off the field at halftime there just saying, hey, not pleased with how they completed the second quarter in this football game.
Well, I feel like they're going to probably play a lot of their starters here a little bit through the third quarter for sure and get a little more rhythm, a little more consistency working both offensively and defensively. So I'm not surprised to see Colt McCoy and company still out there.
McCoy keeps this one after faking to Charles, and he motors for the first down and more to the 32-yard line. Let's take a look at the first half possessions and what happened here. And you see Texas had that fumble. Rice didn't take advantage of it, and I hate to say that's all she wrote, but as it turned out, that was a big play.
Yeah, it was a great opportunity for Rice to put something on the board there, but Texas, they kind of got in gear there at the end of the half and kind of got things going their way, obviously with the 41 points on the board, and there's another opportunity here for Colt McCoy and his offense to come out and start something here in the third quarter.
McCoy came in averaging nearly 4 yards a carry on the run, so he's got better leg action, you might think. This pass hits the defender in the back. That was Andrew Sandejo, the sophomore from Canyon Lake, Texas. And for Texas, the playmakers tonight, Swede, a big one with a pair of receptions, could have had a third. Charles with two scores, and Colt McCoy has really played well.
Now, if you just have those numbers every single ball game, that would be tremendous. If you'd have those three players to be that productive and then just continue that throughout the season, I'm sure Mac Brown and Greg Davis would be very, very pleased with how the offensive performers are putting up numbers.
Texas trying to make it 4-0, and they start Big 12 play with Kansas State next weekend here. That pass incomplete, intended for Cosby.
That ball, that would have been a touchdown if he had got that ball, because they were outmanned out there. They had the play lined up the way they wanted to. The ball just didn't get there. Colt McCoy just threw a one-hopper in there.
You know, and that's something that Mac Brown and Coach Davis will tell us, the offensive coordinator, about. Colt McCoy is such a perfectionist and so hard on himself to say, you know, hey, just play the game. You know, we're all going to make mistakes, but that is the intensity that he plays with.
I mean, just a smart young player, a guy that learned a lot, grew up a lot last season, and had a tremendous freshman season as a quarterback for the Longhorns, and trying to continue that same way here as a sophomore.
A third and 10. He finds the receiver here and near the first down as Reigns makes the tackle.
Well, that's Obanaya.
Yeah,
let's let the game come to him, and I think he's learning to do that a little bit more, Bill.
Yeah, last year he had 29 touchdowns to 7 interceptions. He had 4 TDs and 5 picks coming into this game, and tonight he's played so strong. And it's now a first and 10 at the 22. Escaped a little pressure, looking for an opening. And, boy, he had a couple of guys, easy to say, from up here that were more open than the intended receiver there.
Well, this is a play that he could pull the ball down and run the football. There's no doubt about it. When he's out here on the outside, you'll see that he's going to come to the outside and be able to, he could run down the field. So just let it run here, guys, and see what I'm talking about. Hold it right there. When you see everything is cleared out, when he comes here, there's nothing in front of him, but he's trying to get the ball in there on the pass play to a receiver.
I told him. Just second and 10 at the 22. Charles in the backfield with McCoy. And he is brought down for a loss on the play. Nicely done that time by Todd Moore, the junior out of Houston Side Creek. And loss of 2. 24-yard line.
Well, if he doesn't make this tackle, Todd Moore, number 91, if he doesn't get in, look at the green grass ahead of a speedy Jamal Charles. Would have been a big play. It's a nice play by the defensive tackle, avoiding contact inside, and doing it with one hand, too. Looks like he's got a mitt on that right wrist.
So it'll set up a third and 12 at the 24. Cosby wide left. Swede goes to the right side. McCoy now backs off and takes the snap at the 29. Going for Jones, and complete. Got the first and goal situation. Sandejo makes the stop. But Colt McCoy gets Nate Jones near the 2-yard line.
Well, this is two guys doing a good job here. One, the quarterback throwing the ball out there, and then a receiver running a precision route. You got two deep zone coverage, and he works to the void of the defense behind the cornerback short and on the outside of the safety. This is exactly where you need to throw the football. Nate Jones runs a great route, and ball's delivered right where it needed to be.
Tell you what, FSN crew all over bringing it into your living room. Nice job, fellas. 22 yards on the play, and a first and goal from the 2 now. Miles has already got a pair of scores. and make it a third as he strolls into the end zone. Jamal Charles, and Texas tacks on another TD with 10:17 to go here in the third quarter, and it's 47-7.
Well, a hat trick here now for Jamal Charles with touchdowns. The offensive line doing a good job of maintaining their blocks. The lead block there by the fullback Cobb, and easy picking for Jamal Charles. Nobody really touches him going through there. And you see his numbers on the even here at the three scores.
Nine plays and 54 yards to 251 for Texas. Put up another six. And Bailey comes on for the point after. And it is good. And the Longhorns, 48. The Rice Owls, 7. With 10:17 to go in the third quarter against the Texas Longhorns. And we're ready to kick it off here now as Texas, after that TD by Charles, booted off to the Owls.
See Charles on the sideline. He may get a chance to get a few snaps under his belt here coming in sometime in the third quarter, maybe the next series.
Smith and Shepard are deep for the Owls. And once again, Hunter Lawrence is kicking it off this time and taking at the 1 yard line. Smith, the 20. Oh, somersault, loose football. Play was whistled dead. Texas making sure that Max Message got home about no big kick returns, huh?
You like collisions? Just listen to this.
Yeah. Wow. Eric Jackson that upended him. Oh, what? That was closer to being a fumble than I originally thought. But Rice maintains possession. And it's first and 10 at the 23 for the Owls. Chase Clement, the junior quarterback from Alamo Heights, zings it out to the 30-yard line, and tackle made there as Killebrew in on the stop, and Torn Dixon again the receiver.
Talk much about Robert Killebrew, but he's a pretty good story. I know this young man from his days down at Klein High School. Actually played ball with my son down there and had a good football program, and good to watch him and his career develop here at the University of Texas. Came in here pretty unselfish player, and he's turned himself and Bill into a pretty good linebacker. And one of the best in the Big 12, I think. And he's one of the leaders out there on his defense, and he's very unselfish in what he does. He's not a real vocal guy, but he's a guy that plays with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of passion.
Hill, the ball carrier here, gets the first down for the Owls as he pushes it out just shy of the 35-yard line.
Yeah. We talked with Mac Brown, you know, yesterday about Robert Killebrew and what he means in this program.
Great years. He's one of those guys. Every time somebody says, you know, we ought to get somebody else to step in there, Robert just continues to play good and lead this team.
Well, that time, Robert and his teammates got burned as Henderson rolls across the 50, the first to 10 from the 34, and here end up at the 47-yard line of Texas.
No, Rice getting a positive play here, no doubt about it. Just kind of zing it out there and run against the grain of the defense and get some good positive yardage there.
Easily missed the tackle on the play. They pick up 19 yards, and it's first and 10 at the 47 of Texas. The Owls scored their only touchdown in the final seconds of the first half. Flags everywhere here.
Find out what the penalty is here and sort it out. And
false start, 72 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Bobby Hios again, the miscue.
A little more about Robert. You know, when, you know, back in Klein, I had no idea he's going to come to University of Texas and become a chef and learn how the culinary arts, the culinary stuff. And I don't know what kind of dishes he makes, but they say that it's all pretty good. He's got a lot of fans for his cooking and what he does, but there's a coach that has some question marks about that.
Yeah. More on that a little bit later here. With first of 15 at the 48. Pass complete to Wardlow, Taylor Wardlow, the sophomore. And he is tackled at the 41-yard line.
Well, Rice doing a nice job moving the football here, and Wardle with, I guess, he gets his second grab of the night here for the Owls, just working out there in his own defense there between the linebackers.
Second and four now. Texas, good push inside coming that time, and Aaron Lewis comes up with the tackle. Let's send it down to Emily.
What he has to say.
I have two rules as a head coach. We've had seven guys that have become doctors since we've been at the University of Texas, and I'm not really ready for any of them to operate on me yet, and I do not eat the food of any of our young chefs. So those are the two things that I will wait, and in time I will be ready to do that, but not yet.
Right. What's his hesitation? I don't
blame him. I thought Emily was going to tell me he specializes in roadkill.
Oh, no. Anytime you get a TV show, you know, about your cooking and your skills, you got to be doing something right.
Rice will have to kick it away here. They've had 21 carries of the football for minus 9 yards tonight. Texas run defense has been stout, to say the least. And he's juiced as he juices this one.
Wow.
And is high. Almost a three-pointer. Just about put it through the uprights that time. With juice, and Texas will get it back on the 20. When we come back with the Longhorns controlling it, gets the call now. The freshman, we saw him for a play or two in the first half. Mansfield Summit High School in the Dallas area, and comes in with some incredible numbers as a senior, or as a high school All-American. He graduated early, came in so he could attend spring semester and participate spring football here. And he threw for 24 touchdowns and ran for 14 touchdowns. That Mansfield Summit. And now let's take a look back at that.
Bill Cousins, a former SID at Rice, and how fans of Rice ordered a lot of those tapes from the network through the SID office, of wanting a copy of that, because it was a huge night for Rice football.
Childs hit hard here on the incompletion. Let's check in now with the Dr. Pepper game break. Kentucky, letting you know they are for real.
Yeah, that's a good win for them. Yeah. It really is. It shows that their ranking in the top 25 is certainly of merit.
Well, especially come off that emotional win against Louisville, an in-state rival, and then bounce back and beat a Dumont, Arkansas. Here's Childs showing you his stuff. Wow, just breezed by two people and then scampers out of bounds at the 48-yard line. John Childs, you see the talent.
I see the wheels turning. I see how fast a young man can get out around the edge. When you can accelerate like this, man, you're going to make some yardage. Look at this. He's got a defender there going to get the angle. No way. Sorry, young man.
Who picked off 93? Solomon got hammered here.
You got to come back and block if you're a receiver in Texas. They demand that from their receivers, and Childs is going to get the benefit of that. So.
First and 10 of the 48. You know, that crowd that was saying, well, maybe we've seen enough. We'll go out and head for our tailgate. Wait a minute. Child says, watch this. First down, move the chains.
Now, he's a different running style than the big, tall quarterback that used to play here in 2005. But I tell you what, he's kind of got that guy of a gear out there, don't you
think? That's how he's going to be compared, is he not?
Yeah, I think
he's
so.
He's big, strong. He's not as tall as Vince Young. He's 6'2".
You know what? You know, when you play in the quarterback, you know, you have to learn the ropes there. You know, we talked to Colt McCoy, and we're going to hear from him in just a second about what it takes to play and what he thinks about Childs and how he prepares and how he's has a chance to play well in this year and perhaps in his future. He says he's got a great upside.
First and 10 at the 39, and Childs keeps the football again. Here's Colt McCoy with more about this out for 49 yards.
There you go. Good job.
He's being pretty productive, and he hands this one off. And check it. It was McGee, I believe. Yeah. Vondrell McGee gets his first carry. Freshman from Longview, Texas. And McGee is tackled just at the 15-yard line by Sandejo.
Well, that's just the depth that the Longhorns have at the running back spot, at the quarterback spot, all across the field. And that's what Mack Brown is able to do. They're able to recruit so well and bring in talented players and just put them on the field. And when you see the acceleration, the speed that these backs have, and now you've got the reserve offensive linemen in there getting some repetitions as well. So Mack and getting his offense, getting a lot of players some opportunities here.
McGee again. He breaks a tackle or two or three. He goes inside the 10 down to the 9-yard line.
We talked about recruiting, and you know, one of the things at the University of Texas that I feel like has happened with them since Mack has had so much success here with this program over the last several years, winning 9, 10 ball games, 11 ball games, 6, 7, 8 years in a row. It's just tremendous what they've been able to do. And the amount of talent that they're able to get, you know, they don't necessarily recruit players anymore. They select players. They select the guys they want to play here, and they offer an opportunity to come here. And the reason they come here is because of what they've been able to accomplish over the years.
Second and 4 from the 9-yard line, and McGee just goes splattering into the end zone. What an impressive run by Vondrell McGee.
Well, just power football when you get a chance to continue to run the football, throw the ball down the field, and you open it up with power and speed. You've got different weapons to use, and guys are blocking well inside. Big enough hole there for a lot of folks to go through, and Vondrell McGee doing a good job running the football here, and he's an explosive player as well.
Texas trying to make it 55-7 as the freshman quarterback Childs comes in and engineers an 8-play, 80-yard drive, and he got a bunch of it himself, and then McGee finishes it off. Bailey has already had a career-best 52-yard field goal, tacks on another extra point. And it's all Longhorns, 50 back as, what could they possibly be telling Childs? 55-7. How about nice job, huh?
Greg Davis, I'm sure, just giving a couple of pointers here and there. Just congratulate him on what he's done. And what did you see out there? What did you look like? Why did you hand the ball? Why didn't you hand the ball? Those kinds of things in the zone read. And, you know, one thing about a football player, when they're instinctive, it looks to me like Childs is one of those instinctive kind of guys. You don't have to coach a whole lot.
Yeah,
you just
got
to give them good instruction, and those guys will take care of themselves out there.
Well, and interesting that a freshman would be so assertive like that and say, first couple of times, he just coached himself. Kickoff taken at the 3-yard line, and Smith brought down at the 17-yard line. Well, you're talking about Mack Brown selecting, not recruiting. Well, why do they come to Texas? There is a variety of reasons, but I'd suggest for players, they all want to play in the NFL. Go to that bottom stat.
Well, that's the one right there that I think is the most important. You take 17 players over the first and second round draft picks since 1999 with Mack Brown here, and they've got all these wins and everything that they've got here overall. It's been an impressive run, but when you're able to show kids that you can, through your program, that there's a lot of success where they can perhaps live out their dream to make it to the National Football League, a lot of players like to go through that same system, and they've had great success doing that. What, 9 guys from a year ago made NFL rosters this year, so it's a factory for the National Football League.
First to 10, and this one is complete. As Wardlow motors into Texas territory and takes it down about the 40. We'll see where they say he stepped out of bounds near the 44-yard line of the Longhorns. And Curtis Brown got beat on this pass.
Now Wardlow now with his third catch on the even here, this time getting outside behind the cornerback and nobody out there to cover him. So quarterback does a nice job getting it out there to him. And Wardlow making 3 grabs here and pretty good yardage.
And first and 10 at the 44 now for Texas after a 39-yard play. And Clement, little option, and he stops on a dime and falls forward for a couple. Good pursuit there, time by the Texas defense.
Well, the speed on the Texas defense, you know, you're not seeing the starters out there, but you're seeing a lot of the guys, the up-and-comers that are going to play here and play here in the future. And they've got a lot of speed on the field still defensively. And an option play is something they're going to be able to defend very well. Just watch the linebackers react and run. And nowhere to go for the quarterback.
Second down and 9 at the 43 for Clement. Clement tonight, 16 of 27 in the air for 204 yards. He's had 2 picked off, and he's got the TD pass to Dixon. Here is Dixon. Took it at the 38-yard line. Of course, Colt McCoy resting with 333 yards and 20 of 29 tonight for 3 scores.
First Down Markers brought to you by Overstock.com. With the convenience of shopping at home, you can save up to 70% on amazing deals from Overstock.com. It's all about the oven. 3 minutes and moving here in the third quarter with Texas rolling 55-7. Rice, though, put together a pretty decent drive, and it's a third and four. And a 38. Long count. Clement. Ball got tipped at the line there.
And I'd be surprised if David Bailiff punts his football. Go ahead and go for it here on fourth down. Fourth positive yardage here. And so bringing your second string quarterback in to play one of the receiver spots. You got out there, and James Casey is out as a wide receiver here on this play.
You saw that a couple times in the first half. So an empty backfield here. Fourth and four at the 38. Nice going for it. And again, deflected. So Clement sent them all out. And Zamacho again, back-to-back plays that he got a piece of.
Good job getting your hands up when you get a chance to get up there. And defeats the defender in front of him, gets going towards the quarterback. He sees the arm throw, and go ahead and stick the big paw up there and get you one.
Acho is a freshman. St. Mark's in Dallas is where he high school, 6'3", 243. And Texas takes over on downs now. So Chiles will get his second full series. First to 10 at the 38. McGee, who got the touchdown, trying to circle. Rice continues, but look at McGee. Looked like he was going to be hit for a loss. And he's just about got a first down, about a yard shy maybe.
These guys, they want to play. These guys execute all the time in practice. And you know, games are an opportunity, you know, to come in there and play. And kind of a reward situation for what all you do in practice. And you get up on a football team and you have a chance to get your younger players in the football game and get them experience. It's a good situation for Mack Brown. And for Rice here, they're trying to hang on. They're trying to still do some things defensively to, you know, kind of minimize the damage here.
Second and two. And McGee got the first down. He is just shy of the 50-yard line.
Another flag on the field, Bill.
We'll see what they call.
Look at McGee's number there. Not bad. Five. Is it 43 yards?
Yeah, and a score. Playing about half a quarter.
Number 10, offense, 10 yards into the run. Repeat, second down.
Why would it be 10 yards from the end of the run?
Doesn't seem right, does it?
Not normally.
Been a rule change. We were notified.
I don't know why they do that.
So it'll be second down and eight.
I have no clue on why that was officiated that
way. You're the expert analyst.
I'm an expert, but I don't know how that was officiated. I promise you that.
Chiles on the keeper. Cuts it back across the 50 and then steps out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Joseph Leary makes the tackle. Boy, he just plays with an air of confidence about him, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's just got, you know, great charisma, confidence out there, and steps up. And he's got guys in front of him blocking, too, which really helps. And so you've got some green grass to work with. You can see why they really like him, and they see that he's got tools and just a stable here of talented players that they've been able to recruit and bring into this program. And you know, he's learning behind Colt McCoy, the offense that they run here. He saw Vince Young run this offense, and a big strong guy like that can make something happen.
And off to the races again is McGee, and he is tackled inside the 10-yard line. As Texas getting over the 500-yard mark in total offense once again, and then McGee nearly takes it to the house before Sendejo stops him from making a touchdown.
Well, this is a good run here by the young tailback, but I tell you, it's even a better effort by Sendejo. Makes up some ground and does a good job of running a good angle in the secondary.
as a strong, as, excuse me, the free safety now for this football team and for Rice and getting him down before he get in the end zone. That was a gaping hole there up front that the offensive line created for their tailback.
38 yards on the play. Texas first and goal again, this time from the 7-yard line, inside a minute to go in this third quarter with the Longhorns already cruising. Kyles keeps it, takes it down to the 4. Aaron Williams making the tackle. Well, we were talking before the game, Gary, you're talking about when we found out that Texas was going to use Childs, and not just in this situation, but with McCoy on the field, and you're saying, well, they'll show that. Other people got to prepare for it. Kansas State getting a good look here. That's who they got next week going, wow. If McCoy gets hurt or if they want to change a pace or whatever, what a whole different look he brings.
He definitely does. He's got a different look and feel to him, what his abilities are and his knowledge and his path of the offense. And not that Greg Davis is really opening things up. They're running their core offense here, which is the zone replay. They'll go through three quarters here, and Childs looks like he might get to roll the whole fourth quarter.
McGee tackled there, but Texas knocking on the door again.
We're third and eight from the, or third and goal, I should say, from the 8-yard line, and freshman quarterback John Childs calling the shots. And Childs faked the handoff, keeps the football, tries to show his strength as he lowers his shoulder, and it's stopped near the 2-yard line. Ozugwu and Sendejo make the stop.
Sendejo again, the safety, doing a good job coming on the edge there.
Send it down to Emily Jones real quick.
Okay.
Those youngsters, and they're anxious. they're wanting their time in the spotlight, and Mack Brown not going for it on fourth and goal from the 3, and instead Ryan Bailey will come on for the field goal attempt with Shipley to hold, 55-7, and he knocks this one through, much like an extra point. Mack showing some class there.
10-12 on the year. He's doing a good job, Bailey.
Wow, what a job. The fourth quarter, they just got another field goal here. Our Keystone Light always smooth moment. Well, John Childs fits smooth pretty good. There he is with the Keystone Light always smooth moment. A great run. He's got 8 carries for 72 yards so far.
Fun to watch.
I mean, he'll get over the 100-yard mark if he's allowed to.
Get another opportunity. Get his hands on the ball. And probably will.
And
72 yards. You got Mondrell up over 70 yards. And Jamal Charles, who we haven't seen, get a touch here in the second half.
Charles got 72. Childs 72. And McGee 77 yards rushing. Of course, haven't been with us. Scoring 333 yards passing tonight. Another solid performance of 20-29. And the kickoff comes to Rice, and to bring it out again, a decent return across the 30-yard line. And carrying the football, Patrick Randolph that time for the Rice Owls. So Rice will come back with Chase Clement will continue. Yep, looks like it. As first and 10 from the 32-yard line. The Owls will get into CUSA play next week with Southern Miss. They'll play at Houston the following week. Of course, for Texas, it's Kansas State next week to open conference play in the Big 12, and then the big game with Oklahoma up in Dallas. Oklahoma very impressive again last night, hammering Tulsa in Tulsa. Norton made the tackle that time on the running back for Rice. Bilia Benabo, senior out of Corpus Christi. Second down and 4. Clement. And this one is complete to Beasley. And he is stopped at the 49-yard line. That'll move the chains for the Owls. Curtis Brown makes the tackle.
Nice efficient play there by the quarterback getting it outside.
Got to find some kind of little nugget here to get out of this ball game. David Bayless and his offense here late in the ball game, just getting guys and some repetitions. Guy who hasn't played much in this half at all is their
first
All-American.
And 10 at the 49.
Even Jared Dillard hadn't played much in the second half at all, did he?
No. A little reverse, and Randolph somehow got out of there and then got pummeled near the 43-yard line. Boy, you don't. Loose football, and Clement just quickly pounces on it. Looked like he was going to try to hand it off to Belial Benabo.
Well, I actually like the offense that Tom Herman runs with the Owls. It's a wide-open style of offense, similar to what Texas runs. You know, Tom Herman was a graduate assistant at the University of Texas, the offensive coordinator for Rice, and worked under Greg Davis. And he says he learned all of his X's and O's, really. He credits it to Greg Davis and how he prepares for football games. And very similar operation to what the Longhorns are doing. They're attempting to get it done at Rice.
And a third and nine. Trying to hit Beasley, a little high. Good coverage there by the Texas DBs. And number three, Curtis Brown, covering on the play. Freshman from Gilmer, Texas. Another one of those many players, Gary, has really become very common now for kids to graduate early in football, go to spring ball and enroll in school. Get the jump on things and not necessarily have to redshirt. And the punt by Juiced. Texas trying to stay away from it, hoping it's going to roll in the end zone. And did Rice get there in time to down it? Don't think so. And the Owls will get it back, or the Longhorns will get it back when we come back. Stay with us here on FSN. 58 yards of total offense to 220 for Rice.
And the rushers.
Yeah. Look at that, and we've got 11:53 remaining, and you've got to figure Texas isn't going to throw it too much here as Childs hands this one off, and McGee, 23-yard line.
No, we had a chance to visit with Jamal Charles yesterday. Kind of a fun time. We did a couple interviews with him and talked to him about some things, but, I can tell he's just got a great personality. He's just kind of a quiet guy, but, when you get him engaged and he get a little comfortable with you, you can see he loves it and fun. He talked about Earl Campbell. He talked about Earl's on campus now, doing some rehabilitation, doing some things, and he actually grabs Charles. He looks for him. He hunts him down, trying to give him some coaching points and talking to him about how to protect the football, how to have ball security and do things and worked with him. So it was interesting to hear how all the people around campus are really have his interest at heart, and he's taking that input and trying to make himself a better football player.
Charles keeping that time, and Charles, and we'll tell you a little bit more about those. Send it down.
No one else in the country has, unless somebody else wants Jamal Charles on their shoes, guys.
custom gear.
Chefs, guys going to the clothing business, shoe gear, you name it.
There's Jamal on the side of that shoe. Saw that up close and personal. We're talking. That was our fumble drill too. That was the shoe we were working on in the fumble-itis there in our little interview room, and he's got that all figured out too. So
we had a fumble early tonight, but he recouped very well from that. Childs, the incompletion, and Texas will have to kick it away here, as Ja'Cory Shepherd is deep for the Owls near his own 36-yard line. And Trevor Gerland, sophomore from Katy, Texas, to punt it. Low kick, takes a good roll, feeds right into Shepherd. And he is form tackled to about the 43-yard line. And we'll be back after this word from Dr. Pepper and your local. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, and Emily Jones with you here in Texas. Longhorns 58-7 as Knox carries the football, and for another big loss as Texas
like the defense has decided, you know what, we don't have the shutout, but we sure keep them from having positive rush yards, because now it's 26 rushes minus 4 yards. That's amazing, Jerry.
Yeah, that's minus yardage. You know, you think it's going to be a lot of sacks, but it's really not. The defense has done a good job on that zone replay and tackled the tailback behind the line of scrimmage numerous times tonight.
Your quarterback is John Thomas Shepard, the 6'1", 192-pound sophomore. And this one is complete. Good hit made on the play as well as Knox makes the grab. It's back to near that original line of scrimmage. McElroy and Kelson in on the stop. Drew Kelson, backup free safety. Playing time here tonight. Everybody is on that Texas sideline. This evening, Texas led it 10-0 at the quarter, 41-7 at the half, and quickly scored to start things in the third quarter, and it's been recessed since. This pass is complete over the middle, and close to end will be another first down, as catching the football that time for Rice number 82, John Welch. Welch gets his first reception, and Brown makes the tackle.
You know, we talked to David Bailiff about recruiting and bringing players to Rice, and it was very interesting. You know, he talked about how players that go to Rice, they choose to go to Rice, and their media guy, this is a lot of pictures of, I chose Rice, I chose to go there, and the reason is that Rice prepares their athletes to be very successful after football, and success is in the community. They've had tremendous success there, and he had a fun little comment to us that he talked just about how, with those guys succeeding in life, they expect them to go out in the community, they expect them to be the boss within 5 to 10 years, and really after about 10 years to get that scholarship paid back for.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a kind of an interesting quote from him. So the kinds of players and the kinds of people that Rice has had go through their program over the course of time, it's really tremendous, and what goes on that campus. Got a book of champions they're talking about with all the guys and all the things that they've done on that school with the different career paths. And you've got Supreme Court justices. You just take it on down. There's so much going through Rice historically, and they still play very competitive Division I athletics.
Shepard hands it off to Knox. Texas second unit being just as tough as Jared Norton makes the tackle there. And, of course, Rice recent ongoing baseball success over the years has brought a lot of attention, and yes, there's a way you can be very strong in athletics and very strong in academics.
Gary, you were talking about 10 years be the boss, He also said in 20 years he expects players to have a building named after them. That's how much money they get back to the school.
Yeah, I forgot about that one, but that's part of it too. So it's a lot of successful people come out of Rice University, no doubt about that.
Third and three for the Rice Owls. Shepard completes it across the middle for another first down, and still tugging with the football, number 89, Chance Talbert, 6'5 sophomore out of First Texas, went to Arlington Oak Ridge.
Just execution here. You do a little stop right there. Come up. Linebackers are playing deep, and safety just have to come up and try to hit the big fella and get him down. It's not an easy task, it looks like.
So first and 10 at the 25 for the Owls, 6:50 remaining in the football game. Shepard going for Welch and got him. Welch, a nice catch, nice throw, and there was really pretty good coverage on that play. Welch felt he was interfered with. Brown made the stop, if you will.
That's a good job here catching the football. Just take a look at this. Watch him extend the football at the end of the play here. He's trying to hit the side of the pylon. This is pretty good presence here. Does he get it inside of it?
Wow. Mm.
Not sure they're spotting this ball. It's at the, looks like about the 1 yard line, outside the 1 yard line. I'm not sure if he stepped out there, but the ball was right at the pylon where it was going out.
I'm not going to review it. Welch from Goshen, Mississippi, and it's first and goal from the one. Texas crowd that is still here urging that defense to come up with a stand. Shepard pushes, and he is in. Touchdown, Rice.
So Shepard, it's his first touchdown of the year.
Well, good little drive here, and you know, it pays off with the throw down there, and now you get a chance to run it in for the score, and he does.
6:26 to go in the fourth quarter. The Owls go 8 plays and 56 yards. Takes 3 minutes and 50 seconds. And Shepard with the second TD of the night for the Owls. And the PAT is good. And I beg your pardon, that was Casey with the score. So Rice, another TD, and it's for reasons. Emily Jones with you here as folks have scattered for the most part. But tell you what, Gary, you feel for the players here from both teams that get some valuable experience, you know, having played the game. When you only get to play now 12 times a year, guaranteed, opportunities are far and few between for many of these players. And this is the thrill right now that they're getting extended playing time.
Yeah, a lot of young players are being able to play in this kind of a football game, either from both sides, you know, with Texas and as well as Rice. They're developing themselves to be in a position to, if need be, called upon, you know, later in the season, they'll be able to step up and play well. And overall, there's a chance that, you know, they can perhaps move themselves into some playing time. And realistically, though, once you get into conference play, you're going to be going with your starters. And these guys who are playing on the field right now may not get to see much more action beyond this.
Taking at the goal line, and McGee brings out near the 18-yard line where Texas will take over there.
Well, Bill, we're going to take a look at the Kyocera wireless call of the game, and it was with Limus Swede.
The game, and Swede, who had a big night here tonight. 139 yards in the first half, third most ever by a UT receiver in a half, behind Roy Williams, 180 at Kansas in 2000, and Mike Adams had 141 against Notre Dame in 95. Those are two pretty big name receivers.
I talked about him getting into the mix, getting back, banged up an ankle last week, and got back into it. He's a big play guy, Bill, and they need to have explosive plays from him in this offense, and they know that he's a big part of it. They've got great receivers here. They've got a good trio of receivers out there for Colt McCoy to throw to. So getting a line of Swede back in the action and having a big night is important for this team.
New quarterback, Sherrod Harris, is on for University of Texas. Says the talent does not run dry at the signal calling position. 6'3", 219 out of Arlington, Texas. And Harris running behind Childs now. Childs was impressive in his day. Second and 6. And third down coming up after that short gain that time by Cobb. Antoine Cobb, 6'2", 215, redshirt freshman from Pflugerville, just up the road here. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Live better with savings up to 70% on amazing deals from Overstock.com. It's all about the O.
Thank our hosts here this last evening, John Bianco and Kevin, Sports Information Department of the University of Texas. And had a good time at El Arroyo and here in town with
Mr. McPhail. Take care of us over there.
Clay McPhail, I tell you, I saw him tonight and told him thank you. Well, I'm still feeling it from last night. Just great food. Enjoy it.
He pulled a fajita out of his back pocket for you and said, here, I think Gary left this last night. Here is Harris scrambling and in trouble, and a loss on the play brought down near the 11-yard line.
And I think some of these fans might be going to El Arroyo right now. There's quite a few of them out of here already. Going to enjoy the rest of the evening in Austin. It's been a pretty good effort by the Longhorns overall. And I'm sure they're very pleased with how things have gone for this team. And a lot has been expected of this team, even though there's been a lot of changes, Bill, with the personnel, the staff. You know, done tried to put players on the field and get them ready to play. But, you know, you run into competent teams just much like Central Florida was a week ago. You know, it's not going to be just as easy as you think, just rolling helmets out there. You've got to compete.
Well, that is the case, and what we do is watch those scores that fly by every week. Ball kicked away and taken by Shepard at the 45 and then hit there. And let's send it down to Emily.
As far as offensive linemen are concerned, but they are glad just to have him here at the University of Texas and glad he's just here, period.
That's a great story, Emily, yeah. And I tell you, that's just kind of the credit that the Mac Brown is and how he commits to players. There's another player on this team, too, that has that same story, and that's Tony Hills. And, you know, Tony had a catastrophic injury coming out of high school as well and thought his playing career would be over. You know, and Mac Brown said, no, don't worry about it, young man. We want you to come here. We still want to offer you your scholarship. And they rehabbed Tony, and they worked with him, and he became one of the best offensive linemen that they've had here.
And he's been on some of the all-conference teams.
I'm telling you. And so he thought his playing career was over, but he came to the University of Texas, and Mac Brown didn't expect him to play.
Rice back with the football here now, and James Casey again quarterbacking, and ooh, a big hit. Causes the incompletion near the 35-yard line. It's Curtis Brown again, I believe. Some interesting scores today. You know, Baylor beat Buffalo 34-21. They've got Texas A&M next week and the conference opener for both. How will A&M react after the loss down at Miami on Thursday night? Kansas remains unbeaten, blowing out Florida International, 55-3. CUSA opponent Rice is Houston, who will meet 2 weeks with the winner today. Look at this. The defense comes on, and absolutely no chance for James Casey.
A little blitz there on the outside. And should have made the sack, but he didn't get it. Here's what's coming up next.
Washington and UCLA on FSN. Olsen out for the Bruins, and Cowan last year with 11 TD tosses, and Jake Locker for UW, and no score early going on our Kyocera College Football Saturday continuation from the Pac-10, Washington and UCLA. Put you right out there. By the way, speaking of scores, Iowa State could not stand prosperity after the win over Iowa last week. Huge victory. They lose at Toledo 36-35. Iowa leading Wisconsin tonight after losing to the Cyclones last week. They're up 10-7 over the Badgers. Still on the right.
And Nebraska just a one-point winner. Ooh. In a tough, close game with Ball State, 41-40 in that ball game. And wow, that was one that really surprising to me because I thought that Nebraska really should have handled Ball State fairly easily in that ball game, but it didn't turn out to be anything of the like.
No. And Michigan, Penn State had not beaten much. Michigan comes and beats Penn State today, 14-9. So that miserable start for them will never be forgotten to App State. But they still have things to do in the Big Ten that can be accomplished.
Penn State coming to that ball game ranked 10th in the country. They're definitely going to tumble.
Colorado has pounded Miami of Ohio today, 42-0 the final. Colorado will take on Oklahoma next week in the conference opener and in Boulder. Colorado defense is pretty stout.
Barry Orr. Arsenal going up.
Talking to Dad, hey, how'd it go? So well.
And I think Oklahoma State ran the ball very well up there, over 200 yards rushing that ball game against Texas Tech. So must have been a heck of a ball game in Stillwater. The Cowboys came out on top at the end.
Here is Harrison, the keeper, to the 25 and the 24-yard line. Inside a final minute here is Texas 58, Rice 14. And the Longhorns will stay unbeaten. You know, and anymore, coaches will tell you, of course, fans get grumpy if you don't win by a big margin. They got that tonight. But as we've seen again by just some of what we've gone through, all that counts is the W's.
Yeah, the W's are what really counts. Is. That's what you're measured by at the end of the season. You know how many wins and losses, and coaches are measured by that for sure. And Mac Brown knows it, but he knows that the standard is set so high here at the University of Texas, and it's mainly because of what he's been able to accomplish over the last 8-9 years since he's been here that that bar is raised that high. They expect to win championships here, and that starts with the Big 12 championship and potentially national championships.
Mac's 97th win, and this is 10th season. As that does it, Texas 58, Rice 14 on a banner night for the Longhorns where they wrapped it up early. McCoy 333 yards passing and three scores tonight. For Gary Reasons, Emily Jones, and our entire crew, this is Bill Land saying so long from Austin.